السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم اهدي قلبي وسدد لساني واسلل سخيمة قلبي. آمين يا رب العالمين. Inshallah, we'll begin today's session on the beautiful names of Allah the Exalted, asma Allah al-Husna, with the name of Allah al-Aziz. Al-Aziz meaning the ever almighty. Al-Aziz, the name of Allah al-Aziz, occurs 92 times in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَىٰ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And for Allah is the highest attribute, and He is the exalted in might, the wise. So the name of Allah, Al-Aziz, occurs, as I mentioned, 92 times in the Quran. And Al-Aziz means ذُو الْعِزَّةِ, meaning the one who has all عِزَّةِ, meaning all completely and entirely. Izzah belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what does Izzah basically mean? Izzah has four meanings. The first meaning of the word Izzah is Al-Qadr, meaning honor and dignity. So we learn in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ, that all honor and dignity belong to Allah, to His Messenger, and to the believers. So Al-Aziz means the one who is ever honorable. Then secondly, the word Izzah also means quwwah, or power and might. So we learn in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that He sent two messengers to a people, and then فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثٍ, and then we strengthened them with a third. So meaning we added to their power, to their might, with a third. So Al-Aziz meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is ever powerful, ever mighty. And then thirdly, the word Izzah also means Al-Imtina'. And Al-Imtina'r means to resist and to withstand. So Al-Aziz is the one who is invincible, meaning he is not to be overcome. He is unattainable, meaning it is not possible for people to harm him or to compete with him. And then finally, the fourth meaning of the word Izzah is Al-Qahr and Ghalaba, meaning to conquer and prevail. So we learn in the Quran that a disputant who came to Dawood alayhi salam, he said, وَعَزَّنِي فِي الْخِطَابِ, that this person, this other person, عَزَّنِي, he overcame me, meaning he defeated me in argument. So عَزَّ also means to conquer and to prevail over someone, to overcome them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Aziz, is who? The one who overcomes and conquers and prevails, and He is not to be overcome. Now, keeping these four meanings of Izzah in mind, what does it mean for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Aziz, so this means that He is the most honorable, meaning no one, nobody is more important and more honorable than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that means that we should show that dignity and power and that respect to Him. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Aziz, meaning no one is more honorable than Him, then we should think of Allah in that way. And we should worship Him, and we should stand before Him in that way. We learn in the Quran, Subhana Rabbika Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifun, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is glorified, He is perfect, He is the Lord of all honor and dignity, meaning all honor is His. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Aziz, meaning He has the power to do whatever that He wants, meaning nothing at all is hard for Him. He is the possessor of strength, who faces no incapacity, meaning He does not suffer from any weakness. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Aziz, meaning His might transcends all might and power, so nothing can defeat Him, no one can harm Him, as we learn in the hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, O my servants, you will never be able to harm me. لن تبلغ ضري, meaning you will never be able to harm me. And you will never be able to benefit me. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-aziz, meaning that he is severe in his punishment. And then he is al-aziz, meaning he is the bestower of honor, of power, of might, of strength. And he gives izzah to whomsoever he wills, and he takes it away from whomsoever he wills. As we learn in the Quran, وَتُعِزُّ مَن تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَن تَشَاءُ, that you give honor to whom you will, and you give might and power to whom you will, and then وَتُذِلُّ مَن تَشَاءُ, you humiliate, you bring down whomsoever you will. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-aziz, it means that his friends, his helpers are not to be humiliated. Those who believe in him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also give them honor and dignity, and he will strengthen them with help from himself. Now, when we look at the name of Allah Al-Aziz in the Quran, we see that it is paired with some beautiful names. So first of all, we see that the name of Allah Al-Aziz is paired with Al-Alim. So for example, we learn in the Quran, ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ, that this is the decree of the one who is Al-Aziz, Almighty, and Al-Alim, the one who knows. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's might is with his perfect knowledge. We see that when the creation has some might and power, we see that we begin to abuse our power, or we don't even realize what we are able to do with the power that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. Meaning our power and ability is paired with what? With our ignorance and foolishness, with oppression, with abuse of power, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is free of any such fault. Then we see that the name of Allah Al-Aziz is also paired with Al-Hakim in the Quran. So we learn, wa'lam anna Allaha Azizun Hakim, that you should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is almighty and all-wise. Meaning, again, his power is with his wisdom. He does not abuse his power. He does not oppress with his power. Rather, he is all wise in what he decides, in what he carries out in his creation. And then we see that the name of Allah Al-Aziz is also paired with Al-Ghafoor. Subhanallah, Ghafoor and Ghafar, meaning the one who is ever forgiving. Inna Allaha Azizun Ghafoor. Meaning on the one hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mighty in his punishment, severe in his punishment. And at the same time, he's also forgiving. So the name of Allah Aziz, it instills fear in us. But then this fear should not be such that we are incapacitated by that fear, or we become paralyzed by that fear. At the same time, we have also been given hope that Allah is Ghafoor. We learn رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفَّارُ. He is Al-Aziz, the Mighty, and Ghaffar, perpetual forgiver. And then we see that the name of Allah Al-Aziz is also paired with Al-Hamid, meaning the one who is praiseworthy. So he is the Lord of honor, meaning very honorable. And he's also perfect in his being, which is why he is worthy of praise, whether or not people praise him. We see that when it comes to the creation, a lot of times people may have a lot of power and status, but that doesn't mean that they are, good in who they are, good in what they do, or that they possess any qualities which make them praiseworthy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Aziz and Al-Hamid. He is the Lord of honor, and he is also praiseworthy. And then we see that the name of Allah Al-Aziz is also paired with Ar-Rahim. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْعَزِيزِ الرَّحِيمِ, rely upon the one who is mighty and merciful. Subhanallah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is powerful. He prevails. He is not to be overcome. But at the same time, he is also very, very merciful towards his servants. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mighty, then what is it that we should do? First of all, we should remember that we are the slaves, the servants, the worshippers of Al-Aziz. Realize who your Lord is, the one who is most powerful, the one who is honorable, the one who cannot be defeated, the one who you know, prevails and overcomes. So when you realize that this is your Lord whom you worship, then be confident, be brave, be strong. Yes, things get really difficult at times, but realize that the challenge you face is nothing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The difficulty that you have before you is nothing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With the help of Al-Aziz, with the strength that Al-Aziz gives you, inshallah, you'll be able to deal with it. So realize whose servant you are and whose help you are seeking. And this realization will bring about strength and courage and confidence in you. Secondly, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Aziz, that means that we should realize that all dignity and honor is with Allah. Meaning, if we want to be honorable, then we have to seek it from Allah. We have to seek that honor and dignity from Allah. Meaning by worshiping Allah, not by turning away from Him and not by disobeying Him. You see, sometimes in order to, you know, look good in the eyes of people, or in order, you know, in order to become famous, a lot of times people will do things that are in clear disobedience to Allah. In order to be accepted by people, and in order to be, you know, famous or worthy in the eyes of people, sometimes we bring ourselves down. How? By disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is absolutely, it's not helpful at all. This strategy is never going to work, because dignity comes from Allah. He is the source of dignity and honor. So if we want dignity and honor, then we have to first and foremost be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why we're taught that man kana yuridu al-izzata falillahi al-izzatu jami'a. That whoever desires honor, whoever wants honor, then they should realize that all honor belongs to Allah. Meaning you cannot have it unless and until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it to you. And then we see that yes, there are people who are clearly disobeying Allah, and yet they are, you know, treated with a lot of honor and respect in the world. They attain, you know, a lot of greatness in the world. But remember that izzah is just temporary. It's not permanent. Permanent izzah is in being a servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we want honor, not just in this world. We want it forever, in the hereafter also. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the source of honor. So we should remain true to Him and obedient to Him. And then this also means that we should seek honor in the right way. So for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَإِنَّهُ لَكِتَابٌ عَزِيزٌ. He describes His book that the Quran is an honorable book. Meaning if we want honor, then we better get attached to the book of Allah, because it is also a source of honor. And then thirdly, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Aziz, this means that we should be humble before Allah and also before the servants of Allah. Meaning when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is almighty and all honor is with Him, then we should not think highly of ourselves. Why? Because no matter how high we become, who is still higher than us? No matter how important we become, and no matter what, you know, titles we get, and no matter what we put on our resumes, what pieces of paper we have, still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all honorable. So no matter what we achieve or we don't achieve, we should be humble before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and also before people, meaning before the creation of Allah. So for example, we learn in a hadith that when a servant shows pardon, meaning when a person forgives others, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases that person in honor and dignity. So the way to honor and dignity is not by, bragging or by exerting your power over others. No, it is through the way of humility. And that is what we see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Aziz, the truly honorable one, the powerful, mighty one, the one who is undefeatable, and the one who conquers and prevails.